Let's start. Today we will discuss strategies for food enhancement. What are the strategies that we include for food enhancement? In this most important topic is the tissue culture. Culture of the tissue. What do you mean by the culture? Culture. In science, culture means growing of the microorganism. Okay. Like the bacterial culture. Algae. Okay. Example is the milk. In milk, bacteria automatically grow. Can you name that bacteria? Milk bacteria. Lactobacillus. Okay. Automatically it will grow. So milk is the culture. Clear? In the plant, we use the tissue. So tissue culture means growing of the new plant by the any cell of the plant is known as the tissue culture. It is the method of artificial propagation of plant. Propagation means reproduction. Clear? Propagation means reproduction. And it is by the micropropagation means a small part of the plant is taken to produce the new plant. That's why it is also known as micro propagation. What are the advantages of the tissue culture? In normal plant, it takes lots of time to develop a seed. It takes a longer time. But in micro propagation, within a week, you can grow thousands of plants, hundreds of plants. Okay. And all the plant produce are clone, means genetically similar plant is produced. So if you introduce any superior character in the plant, it will continue. That is known as the production of pure line. Production of pure line. In Mendelism, you have studied what is pure line. Okay, pure line means continuation of superior character. Any doubt? Continuation of the superior character. Suppose a large size potato is produced. So if you take the tissue culture, all plant will produce the large size potato. That is the pure line. And there is no chance of the variation. Minimum chance of variation. This is the importance of tissue culture. Suppose if there is a tobacco plant and it is infected by the tobacco mosaic virus. Listen carefully. Tobacco mosaic virus. So how will you produce virus-free plant? By the tissue culture. Which part of the plant is not infected by the virus? Meristem. How many meristem? How many? Name the meristem plant part. Culture of virus-free plant. Virus or disease-free plant. Yes, two types of meristem is there. Ram and Sam. Okay. Sam and Ram and Sam. Two types of meristem. Third one is the nodal. Nodal means it is found at the junction of the plant. What is going on out there? This is nodal. Okay. Nodal means intercalary. Shoot apical meristem, root apical meristem and intercalary or nodal tissue. These tissue are virus free. Means if you take the cell from this part and make a new plant, these part will be disease free, consisting of virus free or disease free plant. Okay, this is the importance of tissue culture. In the tissue culture, there are mainly 5 to 7 steps. Now we will discuss about the steps of tissue culture. So what is the another name of tissue culture? Micropropagation, cloning of the natural plant. It is also known as artificial cloning. But we take only one species, we don't take the two species. Okay, generally we take the single species. It is not hybridization. So there is difference between tissue culture and hybridization. In Mendel experiment, there was hybridization, law of segregation, law of independent assortment, but it is the single species. SAM, nodal tissue, and RAM, three meristematic part can be cultured. Okay. So note it down immediately. Then I will start new topic. Completed. Okay. Put it in the WhatsApp. That is the steps of tissue culture. Let's start. What are the important and significant step of tissue culture? Okay, so let's start. So first step is the selection of plant part. So which part you are taking? You can take two types of part. First one is the haploid part and second one is the diploid part. So if you take the haploid part, the plant will be haploid and it cannot survive in the environmental conditions. Suppose if it is a higher plant, it will not survive because its main body will be gametophyte. So in case of algae and the bryophytes are lower plants, you can consider the haploid tissue. But in spermatophyte like gymnosperm and angiosperm, you must take the diploid part. Let's take an example. This is the ovule. So which part of ovule is haploid? Which part? All the part of the embryo sac is haploid, but embryo is diploid. So if you take the embryo sac, all the cells are haploid. Examples: synergid, egg. These two cells combinedly called the egg apparatus. Like the Golgi apparatus, so is the egg apparatus. Second one is the antipodals. All these are haploid cells, but nucellus, it is diploid. So there may be a question, if you prepare the micropropagule, so if you take the nucleus, the plant will be sporophyte or gametophyte. Okay. In case of diploid tissue, it will be sporophyte. Kalaja. Kalaja is diploid or haploid? Polar nuclei is diploid or haploid? It is haploid. Okay. Polar nuclei. Now let's take another example of the anther. If we produce the new plant by taking the anther tissue, it will be known as the anther culture, culturing of the anther cells. Okay, again there is two type of cells, haploid and diploid. Suppose we have taken the pollen mother cell, what is it? Diploid. and from the goal of the enter all the cells is diploid, but pollen or pollen tetrad it will form the haploid culture. Clear? If you take the ovule cells, there will be possibility of diploid or haploid. We need to select whatever the requirement. The best tissue for tissue culture is the meristematic. Each cell having the capability to form the new plant means each cell may form the any part of the plant. In like in the human being, zygote can form the any body part. What is the name of this capability? Totipotency. Okay. Totipotency. Totipotency means total. Potency means forming of the new cells. One zygote can form total cells of body, any cell of body. Like the stem cells. Stem cells can form the many part, not the all part, okay. In this case, it is known as the pluripotenty. So, toti means all part. Pluri means many part, not all part. Okay. So, which character is the basis of tissue culture? Totipotency. What do you mean by totipotency? One embryo can form any part of the plant. Selection of plant part. In this case, there may be a cell, there may be a tissue, or you can take any plant part, a special part. Generally, cell is taken. Okay. For cell having the totipotency. Most totipotent cell, meristematic cell. Maximum capability. Because it can form any part of the plant. Okay. Second step is the tissue culture. Second step is if you have any doubt, you can ask. Without any hesitation, okay? Second step of tissue culture. Preparation of sterilized medium. Okay, suppose we have taken a plant part. This one is the meristematic tissue. Clear? So this part may have some types of unwanted microbes, fungus and algae. It will also grow in the medium. So, first we need to sterilize the medium as well as explant. Now what is explant? The plant part that is taken for tissue culture is known as the explant. That is explant. It is the plant part taken for tissue culture. So first cell of tissue culture is known as explant. Tissue culture is in vitro or in vivo? In vitro, like the IVF, in vitro fertilization, it is the in vitro cloning, okay, or micropropagation. There is another name, IVC or IVM, in vitro cloning. Explant, first we will sterilize the explant. So we have taken the any leaf cell, we need to disinfect the cell. For this infection, we can use the different types of chemicals like alcohol, okay, or by steam. If you steam the plant part, all the microbes will die. Clear? laminar air flow. There are many techniques to clean the environment as well as explant. So second is step sterilization. First explant. Second sterilization of nutrient medium. We have also taken a medium in which the bacteria or fungus must not be there. Otherwise, bacteria and fungus will destroy the plant. Okay. There is a special chamber for tissue culture. This chamber is sterilized because in air they are having the microbes, infectious microbes or unwanted microbes. So air must be sterilized. This chamber is known as the inoculation chamber. Like in the hospital, there is ICU. ICU, you know. What is the full form of ICU? Intensive care unit. If you go in the ICU, you means remove your slippers outside and other things. Because there may be an infection from the unwanted infectious microbe. Sterilization of nutrient medium. How will you sterilize the nutrient medium? Medium must be aseptic conditions. Aseptic means without unwanted infectious microbes. Okay? We can use the autoclave. Autoclave, you know, you have seen the microwave oven. Microwave oven. What is in the oven? If you put something in the oven, there will be microwaves. It will boil the substance as well as microbes will be killed inside the microwave oven. It is just like the autoclave. Suppose if you are using the any seizure or any instrument, so it must be sterilized in the autoclave because it may be infected. Your head must be sterilized. Autoclaving of instruments and utensils, whatever you use, and so that is the nutrient medium, or it is known as the culture medium, and this is known as the explant. This is the explant.
Sir, what does it mean by laminar airflow?
Laminar airflow. Actually, there is a UV light. In UV light, if anything comes, it will be killed by the UV light. Laminar airflow means it will remove the bad air, and air will be sterilized automatically. With the help of the UV light and other methods, we can sterilize the air. The third step is the inoculation, and fourth step is the incubation. It is looking like the homonyms, so don't confuse. Inoculation and incubation. Can you differentiate between these two? Inoculation and incubation. Inoculation. We have disinfected the explant. Okay, this is the plant part that we have taken. After the disinfectation, we will transfer it in the culture medium. This step is known as inoculation. Transfer of sterilized explant into medium, culture medium, that is known as inoculation. Don't confuse, okay? Many times it is asked in the examination, what is inoculation, what is incubation. Now in incubation, we will start the growing of this plant cell into the new plant. This is the incubation. Growing or starting. Culturing of explant. Any doubt? Okay, if we take the endosperm, take a peek. If we take the endosperm, what will be ploidy on the plant? Triploid. Because endosperm ploidy is 3M. Okay. If we need the, yes.
So what is autoclave of instruments?
Autoclave of instruments. It is microwave oven like the machine. We input, we put all the things inside the medium and it will be sterilized automatically. Okay, by the microwave, any bacteria or virus or anything will be in the utensils. It will be killed by the microwave. Autoclave, it is a machine. Now, next is the starting of the growing of explant. So there are two cases. First one, if we take the cytokinin and auxin in a specific ratio, if the quantity of cytokinin will be more, then it will differentiate to the shoot, means shoot formation will start. Shoot means stem. Stem formation will continue. That is the culture medium. You have already studied in plant growth and regulation. Low cytokinin, high auxin, it will promote shoot formation. This is the most important question, maybe you ask in the NEET. Cytokinin and auxin is more than one. What will it differentiate? Stem formation. Second one is the, if auxin concentration is more and cytokinin is less, what will it promote? Root formation. So we will use one by one. First we will promote the shoot formation, then in next step, root formation. Clear? It will form the, so from explant, it will form the callus. From callus, it will differentiate into the suspension medium. Then differentiation. There are more steps. Fifth, callus. Can you define the callus? After the explant, it will form the uniform mass of cell. It is just like the meristematic cell. There is no differentiation in parenchyma, colenchyma, and sclerenchyma. All cells are equal in shape and size. That is the callus. Undifferentiated mass of cells from explant will form the callus. No any differentiation. Okay. Suspension, we use the different types of medium to grow the callus. If we use the different medium, it will form the different types of plant variety. Okay. Suspension. Polyethylene glycol. That is the PEG. Different type of suspension or medium, like the solvent you can use. Differentiation. We use the fixed ratio of plant growth regulator. You have already studied five types of PGR. Cytokinin, auxin, gibberellin, ethylene, abscisic acid. According to condition, you can use different types of growth regulator. Cytokinin more, shoot differentiation. Auxin more, root differentiation. Okay. It will differentiate the root and the shoot. Means stem and root formation will start. In this case, it is known as the, now it is plantlet. What is this? Plantlet, or it is just like the seedling, because seed is germinated. After the seed germination, it will form a small plant. That is the plantlet, or it is just like the seedlings. In this case, it may be infected by the other agents. So for preventing from infection, we use the greenhouse. We use the greenhouse like condition. This system is known as the hardening. What is this? Hardening means simply making this resistant to the environmental conditions. Suppose in the hospital, there is a child delivered before 9 months. Then what will doctor do? They will transport the child into the ICCU. ICCU is for the small child. Okay. ICCU. So, it may be susceptible for many diseases. So, first we will make it more resistant to the environmental conditions. We use the greenhouse. We will transfer it into the greenhouse. Which type of conditions are there? Low light condition, high humidity condition, and optimum temperature. It will make the plant to withstand the outer external harassing conditions. Because outside there is more microbes, more virus, bacteria, it will infect the plant. So we transfer it step by step. Then most complex step, environment. Optimum temperature, hardening. This system is known as the hardening. Transferring of the plantlet from nutrient medium to greenhouse. Then we will transfer it into the soil. Because soil is the reservoir of many pathogenic microbes. To prevent it from infection, we use the hardening. Okay. We can use the greenhouse, we can use the any chamber, we can use the lab also. Any doubt? Greenhouse means low sunlight and optimum temperature, humidity control, everything we can control in the greenhouse. Means the simulated environment for the growing of the plant. Taken the picture. Okay, that is the hardening. So there will be different types of questions in the examination. After the hardening, at the last step, we will transfer it into the soil. Okay. Last step, transfer it into soil. There will be one case. In this case, we can transfer one part of this to form the two seedlings. That is known as the subculture. What is this? Subculturing. We can make different plantlet. So from single cell, how many plant we can prepare? 100 plant, 1000 plant. Within 2 to 4 weeks, in a month, we can produce the many seeds. Okay, and virus free, of the superior quality soil. At last, plantlet will be transfer to natural environment. The The most important use of tissue culture, it is done into the genetic engineering, where genetic engineering, this is also known as the rDNA technology, it is also known as biotechnology. So there will be positive and negative effect of these newly prepared plant. For this, we organized a committee that is known as the Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. It will decide what are the advantages and disadvantages of newly prepared plant. Genetically Engineering Approval Committee, GEAC. We use the single species. Here, new plant is just like the parental plant. So this is the somatic cells, not the germ cells. We have taken the somatic cells. That is also known as the soma clones. What is this known as? Soma clones. It is not somatic hybrid, okay? It is different. It is not somatic hybrid. So don't confuse. Somatic hybrid is different. We take the two species in the somatic hybrid. But in soma clones, only one species. There will be question in the examination. Somatic hybrid, two species. Soma clones, one species. Any doubt? Okay. In the next class, we will continue the dairy farming and the poultry farming. Clear?